Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome to Tile Coach. I'm Isaac Ostrom. I'm super stoked to be working on this project here. Check out what I'm doing. I'm going to be putting some self-leveling underlayment down on a plywood subfloor because I'm installing an RSS, that's Revolutionary Shower Systems, foam pan. I'm not sponsored by RSS, just a small company that I love to support, so check them out if you want. Okay, so the order of operations, and I've done videos on concrete slab with self-leveling underlayment, but this is different. I don't think I've ever done a video on a plywood subfloor with self-leveling underlayment. So I'm going to be using Custom's LevelQuick because it's easy to get. It's usually found at your Home Depot or your custom building product supplier. But what I have here is, you can see I got my lath down. But before I did that, the first thing I did is I took some duct tape, and what I did is I sealed my perimeter. You can see the tile is already installed out here. If that tile wasn't there, I'd probably have to use some of this foam to build myself a dam so the leveler doesn't just run out. But in this instance, I have about 3/4 of an inch of tile going around, so that acts like a little dam. So I did duct tape going around the whole perimeter here, including the bottom plate that's sitting on top of the subfloor. I just don't want any self-leveler to run under that. So after I got the duct tape up, I used expandable foam, the stuff that comes in a can. You can see I got my drain hole, so obviously I needed to create a dam there. Also, there was a void in the bottom plate here. So anything that's big that needed support, I used that foam to create little dams so that the self-leveler doesn't run, because it runs like water once you pour it out. I also went over the seams with duct tape. So once I got the foam in and the duct tape on, I went ahead and applied the primer over all of the plywood to give it a nice surface to bond to. Then after I applied the primer, I went ahead and stapled my galvanized lath down. These sheets of lath, you can get them at Home Depot or Lowe's. They come in 2.5 by 8 foot lengths, and I cut them to size, put them in. One pretty easy way to cut the lath is with your angle grinder. You can just leave your diamond wheel on there and it cuts through it pretty cleanly. After I got it placed, I used my DuoFast stapler to fasten the lath down to the subfloor. I went about every six inches with a nice 3/8 galvanized staple. These staple guns are really slick. I use them for hanging wire when we're floating walls or any lath where we need it. It's the CS5000 DuoFast stapler. The next thing I needed to do was find out how much self-leveler is needed for this floor. That's really important, because you want to have it all pre-mixed before you lay it, and you don't want to have to run out and mix more or mix way too much. The first thing I like to do is find my high spot in the floor. And so I found that this is the highest point. Put my 4 foot level down. You can see how, and it's not on any shims there, it's just laying right on the lath. You can see how out of level that floor is from that point to that point. So I place shims, and so that's a 3/16 and a 1/16 for 1/4 inch. And then I'm almost level there. I'm still even a little bit low there. Put another 1/16 down and I'm closer. And I did the same thing to find a level point there. It actually slopes even more down to there. So my high point is right here. I'm 3/8 right here. And then I'm another 1/16, what is that? That's 7/16 there. And then it goes to about a 1/16 there, from there to there. So I know that's a lot of information to take in, but if I want a 1/4 inch minimum, because I need to get up over my lath, the lath is about 1/8 inch thick. So I want at least 1/4 inch on my highest point. And if I'm 1/2 inch higher from my low point, and it's pretty consistent going this way, if I'm a half inch higher, then I'm gonna need like 3/4 over there if I have a quarter at my high point. And so over the average, so I'm taking 1/4 inch to 3/4, the overall average thickness is going to be a half inch. 1/4 inch and 3/4, and so the middle would be a half inch. So if one bag is gonna give me 1/4 inch, that means two bags should be half inch average for this area, for this 20 square foot area. And again, and so when I mix it, I probably won't dump them all out. I will probably leave a little in the bucket because I don't want it to overflow and have too much LevelQuick down there. And it's really important to use LevelQuick under these foam pans, because if you think about it, if you're sloped that much, over half inch of slope over 4 feet, put that foam pan in and the water's gonna run this way, it's not gonna drain into the drain. So everything needs to be level. It's rare that you have a level subfloor. Sometimes it happens, but I rarely see it. So I just count on doing this every time I use a foam pan. The house flipper tile guy, when he set his tile, you can see how out of level this floor is. And there's actually a crown in the floor because there's a girder that goes right here. And so the bubbles on that side of the level going from there to the girder, and then from there, the bubbles go in the opposite way. So there's a crown in the floor. And again, if you're trying to set a foam pan on this and there's a crown, it's not good. We want a nice level surface. So a lot of info there. I hope you were following along. If not, just go back and rewatch. I'm gonna go down and start mixing up the LevelQuick. All right, before I mix up, I just wanna take a minute to tell you how grateful I am and making these really cool videos. Thank you for being a part of it, and I'm so glad you're here. I got my two bags of LevelQuick. One of the nice tools that I'm gonna be using is this bucket liner that I got from my good buddy Paul. This is actually, it's called a bucket saver. And you can see it has measurement lines, which is really cool. You saw me using the little paint bucket that had measuring lines. You can do that too, but it's really nice to have a bucket liner that already has the measurements in there. So let's see what we have here. We have, I'm going to do 5.5 quarts of water, and that should give me a good mix. You want to get your buckets both filled with water, ready to go before you start mixing. Here I go. I'm going to go ahead and put the LevelQuick in. I'm going to be putting the whole bag in here, the entire bag, mixing it at once. Pour slow or it'll spill out like that. I'm going to take my drill, and you can use an egg beater, or I got this mixer. I don't use it very often. I'm gonna slow it down and just go all the way to the bottom and mix it up. Got a pretty good mix on that one. I'm gonna switch over to this one. All right, so I got my two buckets up here. I always like to bring my mixer up and give them another spin right before I pour them. That way, if it started to set just a little bit, it'll break it back up and make it pour easier. Okay, there's not much to it. I'm gonna be using a flat trowel. This is a Marshalltown light. This is the same trowel I'll use to float walls and stuff. They have other tools like spike rollers and stuff, but for something this small, you can just help it along with this. So there's not much to it. I'm just gonna dump it out and then use my trowel to help it find its level. So we'll start with the first bucket. And I start where it's deepest. So I know there's probably gonna be a full bucket on this end. Oh yeah, it's working good. Okay, got one bucket down. I'll take my other bucket, and I'm only gonna pour about half of this one, because again, I don't wanna pour too much. And that's working good. My little dam is working good. So the expandable foam that I've used, so actually, I only have about maybe a quarter bucket left. So let's see how this does. So yeah, this expandable foam, it's already hard. I probably installed it about an hour ago, but it gets tack-free in about 20 minutes, and then you can do your thing. It'll still be soft, but it's all the way hard now. So that's pretty much it. I mean, it did its thing. I'm just gonna make sure that it seeks its level. So yeah, I probably have a good quarter inch at my high spot. And it ran down really nicely. And it seems like as long as you have a nice thick layer of the self-leveling underlayment, that it does a really good job of finding its own level. I mean, so that's pretty much it. I mean, I can tell that after working it around a little bit, that it's gonna be nice and level. That's really all I need to do. The areas that you usually have trouble finding, you know, having the self-leveler find its level, are where it gets real thin, and especially on concrete, the water tension will want to hold it back instead of pouring out. So as long as you get your trowel over it and help it find its level, man, this one went really well. All right, so all wrapped up. I got my buckets cleaned out. The nice thing about those bucket liners is I still had about a quarter bucket full of the self-leveler, and I can just leave it in there. It's Friday, I don't have to worry about dumping it out somewhere. I'll just let it harden up over the weekend and then just pop it right out of the bucket. So that's really cool. What a great Friday. Work a half day, get some self-leveler down. If you need help on your projects, I have one-on-one coaching available at tilecoach.com. I have 30, 45, and 60-minute sessions that you can book. So thank you very much for your support. Thanks for joining me. There's a ton of other videos you could be watching, but you chose to watch this till the very end. I love you. I love being your tile coach. We'll see you on the next video.